Welcome to my new section, epithelial tissue or otherwise epithelium. So before that, you have to know what is a tissue. Okay, so we know that cells are the body's smallest functional unit, isn't it? They are grouped together to form tissue, each of which has a specialized function like blood muscles. Okay, got it. So cells are the body's smallest functional unit which are grouped together to form tissue. Tissues are grouped together to form organs like heart, stomach, brain, etc. So the organs are grouped together to form system. So each of which perform a particular function. For that example is the digestive system. Got it? So the tissues are grouped together to form organs, but the cells are grouped together to form a tissue. The tissues are grouped together to form organs. Then the organs are grouped together to form a system like digestive system. Okay. So let us see which are the types of tissue. The tissue, it is divided into four types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and nervous tissue. So today my session is about epithelial tissue or epithelium. So how the epithelial tissue is defined? Let us see how the epithelium is defined. So epithelial tissue, they are the sheet of cells that cover the external surface of the body. They line the internal cavities and hollow organs. Okay, so they are the sheet of cells that cover the external surface of the body, lines the internal cavity and the hollow organs. What are the features? They are avascular because there will be no blood supply. High mitotic rate. They are rest on a basement membrane. Okay, now we are standing on a floor. Like that, the epithelium will be rest on a basement membrane. Then some cells, they may show surface modification. Yesterday I told that the cells, they are having cilia. Like that, here they will show some modification. Then the morphology and the functions of the cell may differ from the basis of their location. These are all the characteristic features. There will be no blood supply, high mitotic rate. They will be rest on the basement membrane. The cells show some surface modification. Morphology and functions of the cells may differ on the basis of the location. Let us see the function. They help in the protection, absorption, secretion and exchange. Let us see some surface modification. Yesterday's class in the cell I told you that about cilia and microvilli, isn't it? Cilia, it is a minute hair-like projection from the surface of some epithelial cells. They are formed by microtubules and they are highly motile. So where they are located in the respiratory tract and uterine tube. Okay, so they are the minute hair-like projection from the surface of the epithelial cell. Next, while coming to the microvilli, there are two types of microvilli: regular microvilli and irregular microvilli. Irregular microvilli, it is having brush border. Where you can see it in the gallbladder. Okay. Then regular microvilli, they are having striated border. You can see it in the intestine. So the cilia, we told that it is motile. But the microvilli, they are small non-motile finger-like projection from the cell membrane. That is the main difference between the cilia and the microvilli. Okay, so microvilli, they are the small non-motile finger-like projection from the cell membrane. There are two types of microvilli: regular microvilli and irregular microvilli. Regular microvilli, they are having striated border which you can see in the intestine. Regular microvilli, they are having brush border which you can see it in the gallbladder. So what will be the function of the microvilli? Increase the surface area and helps for absorption. Isn't clear? So microvilli are the small non-motile finger-like projection from the cell membrane. Two types of microvilli, regular microvilli and irregular microvilli. Regular microvilli, they are having striated border. Irregular microvilli, they are having brush border. While coming to the function, they increase the surface area and helps for absorption. Next, while coming to stereocilia. Stereocilia, they are long, non-motile, branched microvilli. They lies in the vas deferens and epididymis. Then, what about their function? They helps in absorption. So, which are the modification? Yes, cilia, microvilli and stereocilia. Okay. Let us see the classification of the epithelium. The epithelium, it is divided into simple epithelium and stratified epithelium. Again, the simple epithelium, it is divided into simple squamous, simple cuboidal and simple columnar. Okay. Then, stratified squamous, stratified cuboid, stratified columnar and transitional epithelium. Again, the squamous epithelium, it is divided into keratinized and non-keratinized. So, how the epithelium is classified? The epithelium is classified into simple and stratified. Stratified epithelium is also known as compound epithelium. So, simple means there will be one layer. Then, what about the compound epithelium? Two or more layers. Then, we are having pseudo-stratified layer. Pseudo means false. We can see that we can appreciate the pseudo-stratified with two or three layers. But actually, it is simple type. Okay. So, the simple epithelium is again divided into simple squamous, simple cuboid and simple columnar. Stratified epithelium is divided into stratified squamous, stratified cuboid, stratified columnar and transitional epithelium. Again, the stratified, the squamous epithelium is having two types. Stratified squamous keratinized epithelium, then stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. Okay. So, next while coming to the simple epithelium. Simple means there will be single layer of cells. Stratified means already I told that stratified is also known as compound epithelium. So, there will be numerous cell layer. Pseudo-stratified means false epithelium. So, the epithelium consists of a single layer of cell that attached to the basement membrane. But not all the cells will reach the surface. Okay. So, three epithelium, simple epithelium, stratified epithelium and pseudo-stratified epithelium. Then, while coming to the squamous epithelium. Squamous means flattened. So, the height of the cells being much less as compared to the width. Squamous means the epithelium which lies on the basement membrane will be flat. So, cuboidal epithelium, what about the cuboidal epithelium? The height of the cell is about their width. Then, what about the columnar epithelium? The cells are much taller while compared to their width. That is the main difference about the squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and columnar epithelium. Squamous means flattened. Cuboidal means their height of the cell will be same as their width. Then columnar means their cells are much taller than their compared to their width. So here you can see the simple squamous. So this is the simple squamous epithelium. They are having the flattened cells. Next, while coming to the cuboidal epithelium, their height and length will be, their height and breadth will be same. Okay, then simple columnar, they are having taller cells while compared to the width. So, here you can see the pseudo-stratified epithelium. Pseudo means false. They are all lying in the basement membrane, but some cells will not come to the surface of the basement membrane. Okay. Here you can see the stratified squamous epithelium. Here you can see the stratified squamous epithelium with non-keratinized. Non-keratinized means there will be no keratin layer. Here you can see the keratinized layer. Next, while coming to the stratified columnar. This is the stratified columnar epithelium and here you can see the transitional epithelium. So, the most superficial layer will be like umbrella shape. That is the main difference in the transitional epithelium. So, simple epithelium, the simple squamous epithelium, the height of the cells being much less as compared to their width. Their cytoplasm will be a thin layer. Their nuclei will be produce a bulging to their cell surface. The nucleus can be oval or flattened. Okay, so where it is located? The lining of the blood vessel, alveoli of the lung, and the internal body cavity. Their function is about the transport of the substance, gases diffusion, then filtration of the fluid. Okay. What is Simber's squamous epithelium? The height of the cell is much less as compared to their width. The nucleus of the cells will form only a thin layer. The nucleus is oval or flattened. So, where the location of the Simber epithelium, you can see it in the lining of the blood vessel, alveoli of the lungs, and internal body cavity. Look at this picture. You can see that they are having the flattened cells. Here you can see the flattened cells with oval nucleus. Okay, so inside that the cytoplasm will form a thin layer. Is it clear? So they are about flattened cells. They are having oval nucleus and the cytoplasm is about a thin layer. Where you can see the Simber epithelium, you can see it in the alveoli of the lungs. Then you can see it in the blood vessels. Linings. Okay. Next, while coming to the Simber cuboidal, already I told that the cuboidal epithelium, the height of the cells will be same as their width. So the nuclei will be usually rounded and centrally placed. So where they are located, you can see it in the thyroid follicle, duct of glands, surface of ovary. Their function is about secretion and absorption. Okay, so in Simber squamous epithelium, what about their cells? The cells are flattened. You can see oval or flattened nucleus. Here in the Simber cuboidal epithelium, the height of the cell is about the same like their width. The nuclei are usually rounded and where they are placed, they are centrally placed. Then the location, thyroid follicle, duct of glands, surface ovary. Then, what about their function, secretion and absorption? So, here you can see the cuboidal epithelium. Their height and width is same. Okay, then centrally placed nucleus, rounded nucleus here you can see. Okay. Next, Simber columnar epithelium. Already we told that the cells are taller while compared to the width. Then, if the cells are much taller, their nuclei will be elongated and lower half of the cells. Where they are located? They are located in the lower half of the cells. Then some cells, they will bear cilia or microvilli. Already we told that the cilia, they are motile. They are finger-like projection. Microvilli, they are non-motile. Okay. So, the microvilli is again divided into two types. In previous slides, I already told that the microvilli is divided into regular microvilli and irregular microvilli. Regular microvilli, they are having striated border which can be seen in the intestine. And irregular microvilli, they are having brush border which can be seen in the gallbladder. Okay, so what about their function? Secretion in the stomach. Then in lungs, the cilia moves the mucus and uterine tube, the ova. Okay, so it helps in the absorption. The microvilli helps in the absorption. Is it clear? So the Simber columnar epithelium, the cells are much taller while compared to their width. The nuclei are elongated. Location, they are situated in the mucous membrane of the stomach and the intestine. They are microvilli of two types. Regular microvilli and irregular microvilli. Okay. Here you can see the cells which having taller. Okay. Then the width is smaller. So then they are having elongated nucleus. So in the flattened cells, that means in the Simber epithelium, squamous epithelium, you can see the flattened nucleus or oval nucleus. In the cuboidal, you can see the round nucleus. Here you can see. That means in the columnar epithelium, you can see the elongated nucleus. See, here you can see the columnar epithelium. This is the columnar epithelium. You can really appreciate the columnar epithelium. Okay, this is the columnar epithelium with elongated nucleus. Next one is the pseudo-stratified epithelium. Pseudo-stratified epithelium means they consist of single layer of cells that attach to the basement membrane. But not all the cells will reach the surface. Some cells are short and some others are columnar. So either these cells can be about cilia or stereocilia. Is it clear? So the pseudostratified, they are known to be false epithelium because they consist of single layer of cells that attach to the basement membrane. But not all the cells will reach the surface. Out of this, some cells are short and other columnar. They bear cilia or stereocilia. We can see the pseudostratified epithelium in the auditory tube, ductus deferens and male urethra. The ciliated pseudostratified epithelium, you can see it in the trachea, and stereocilia in the epidermis. Okay. So I hope that simple epithelial tissue is clear. So which are the three types of simple epithelium? Simple squamous, simple cuboidal and simple columnar epithelium. Next, while coming to the stratified epithelial tissue. Stratified epithelial tissue, they are numerous cell layer. Okay, so before that itself I told that stratified means compound. So two or more cell layers will be there. So the outermost layer is flat or squamous cell. Deep to superficial, either columnar, cuboidal or even polygonal cells also you can be seen. So how the stratified squamous epithelium is divided? It is divided into two types. Stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, where you can see, no, you can see it in the esophagus, lining of wet cavity, including the mouth, esophagus, rectum and anal canal. So the surface cells are nucleated and living cells. Okay. Next, here you can see it in the diagram. This is the stratified squamous epithelium. So here you can see two or more layers. Most outermost layer is flattened cells. How they are appreciated? They are having flattened cells. Here you can see the most superficial layer to the basement membrane. You can see the columnar cells. Here you can see the cuboidal. Then it can be the polygonal. Okay. So most outermost layer, it is flattened cells or squamous epithelium. Look at this diagram. The most outermost layer, it is made up of flattened cells or the squamous cells. Here you can see the polygonal cells. So this is the stratified squamous epithelium. Okay. So next is the keratinized epithelium. So the outermost layer of the skin, it contains the dead cells. So they will lose their nuclei. It is called stratum corneum. So the dead cells, they are filled with some keratin protein. So in the palm, sole, stratum cornea, it is thick, whereas the rest of the body, it is thinner. Okay, so for that example is the epidermis of the skin. So keratinized is the skin. Example for the keratinized is the skin. Non-keratinized epithelium, esophagus, rectum and anal canal. So what about their function? Protection. Then keratin, it prevents the dehydration. Is it clear? So there are two types of stratified squamous epithelium, stratified squamous, keratinized epithelium and non-keratinized epithelium. So where you can see the non-keratinized epithelium, you can see it in the mouth, esophagus, rectum and anal canal. The keratinized epithelium, you can see it in the skin. So what about the function of the keratin? They prevents the dehydration. And any other function? Protection. Okay. So this is the slide for stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. Here you can see the keratin layer. Okay. So this is an example for palm of the hand. But while we are taking the example for stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, you cannot make out the keratin. Okay. Next, while moving to the stratified cuboidal or either columnar. So two or more layer of the cuboidal or columnar cells. It is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. If it is columnar cells, then it is stratified columnar epithelium. Where they are located? They are located in the exocrine glands, duct of the exocrine glands, like our sweat gland, pancreas and salivary gland. Okay, so stratified cuboidal means two or more layer of the cuboidal epithelium or cuboidal cells. Then if it is stratified columnar, then you can see two or more layer of the columnar cells. Then what about their location? They are located in the exocrine gland. Where in the exocrine gland? Depths of the exocrine gland like sweat gland, pancreas and salivary gland. Here you can make out the stratified cuboidal epithelium. You can see the two or more layers of the cuboidal cells. Okay. Here you can see the stratified columnar epithelium. So how the stratified columnar epithelium is made up of? Two or more cells of the columnar cells. Okay. Next, while moving to the transitional epithelium. Transitional epithelium is also known as urothelium. Why it is known as urothelium? It is found in the excretory passage of the urinary system. Okay. They are having two nuclei. So the cells are visible in the superficial layers of the surface cell. So this transitional epithelium is multi-layered. So multi-layered means 4 to 6 layers. The most deepest layer, either it can be columnar or cuboidal. The middle layer is made up of polygonal cells and superficial layer it is made up of umbrella cells. Their plasma membrane contains special glycoprotein. So if it is the transitional epithelium, then what will be their function? Protection from toxic present in urine, and they act as a osmotic barrier. Okay, is it clear? So why it is known as urothelium? They found in the excretory passage of the urinary system. Okay, this is the diagram of the urothelium or otherwise transitional epithelium. Here you can see the binucleated. This is the binucleated. Two nuclei you can make out here. Okay, so most layer, it is the superficial layer is the umbrella cells. The deepest layer, either it can be cuboidal or columnar. So the middle layer, it is the polygonal cells. Okay, so this tissue and the four types of the tissue is very important. So epithelial tissue can be, as such, it can be asking for the exam. Remaining tissues will be continuing for the next coming days. So thank you. Thank you for watching.